Hello, welcome you all. Myself Deepmala Meena, Assistant Professor in Physics, Government College, Kota. In last previous video, we have discussed about the center of mass. In today's video, we will discuss about linear momentum and its conservation, and also motion and acceleration of center of mass. First, we will study about motion of center of mass. As we know, the position vector of the center of mass of the system of particles is r c equals to 1 by m summation I equals to 1 to n m I r I. Here r c is the position vector of center of mass. We can write this r c or r c m here, where n is the total number of particles in the system and m is the total mass of the system, and mi is the mass of ith particle and ri is the position vector of ith particle. Now differentiating this equation with respect to t, we get drc upon dt equals to 1 upon m d upon dt summation of I equals to n mi dri. We can write this Vc, velocity of center of mass, and here 1 by m, mi dri upon dt, which is the velocity of ith particle. Now we can write Vc equals to 1 upon mp, where p is the total momentum of the particles. Now we can write p equals to mvc, where p is the total momentum of the system. Hence, from above equation it is clear that total momentum of the system is equal to the product of total mass and velocity of center of mass of the system. We are showing here mvc. If no force acting on the system, then we can say p equals to 0, means momentum equals to 0. So we can write mvc equals to 0 and vc equals to constant, means in absence of external force, the velocity of the center of mass of the system remains constant. Here vc equals to constant. Now acceleration of the center of mass. From the equation of motion of the center of mass, we have Vc equals to 1 upon m summation of I equals to n mi vi. In previous slide we have proved this. Differentiating this equation with respect to t, we get dvc upon dt equals to 1 upon m summation of I equals to 1 to n mi dvi upon dt. We can write this acceleration of center of mass and here acceleration of I particle. So we can write ac equals to 1 upon m summation of I equals to n mi ai. This is the force of the I particle, and we can write the full term as force acting on system. So we can say F equals to MAC, where F total force acting on the system, as total internal force acting among the particles is 0. Now we will study about the kinetic energy of the system of many particles. For this, let we have a n particle system. This is our n particle system. And the velocity of ith particle is vi. If we are considering ith particle here, then the position vector from origin of ith particle is ri. And if here is the center of mass of the system, then the position vector of ith particle regarding with respect to center of mass will be rci. And the position vector of center of mass from origin will be rc. then kinetic energy of ith particle will be half mi vi square. We can write this half mi vi dot vi. If position vector of ith particle is ri and from center of mass is rci, then from this figure we can write ri equals to rci plus rc. Differentiating with respect to time this equation, we get dri upon dt equals to drci upon dt plus drc upon dt. We can write this vi equals to vci plus vc, where vi is the velocity of particle about origin and vci is the velocity of particle about center of mass. By substituting the value of vi in the equation of kinetic energy, half mi vi dot vi, we can write eki equals to half mi vci square plus half mi vc square plus mi vci dot vc. And this is the expression on solving this. Now the total kinetic energy of the system is summation of I equals to 1 to n and eki. Here n total number of the particles and this is the kinetic energy of ith particle. So we can write I equals to 1 to n and putting the value of eki from here. We get ek equals to I equals to 1 to n half mi vci square plus vc. Summation of I equals to 1 to n mi vci plus half m vc square. From the definition of the center of mass, summation of I equals to 1 to n mi rci equals to 0. So we can write mi vci also equals to 0 and the kinetic energy of the system will be I equals to 1 to n half mi vci square plus half m vc square. Here this term is the translation kinetic energy of the center of mass and this term is the sum of kinetic energy of individual particles due to its velocity about center of mass. From above equation, from this equation, it is clear that kinetic energy of many particle system is equal to the sum of translation kinetic energy of center of mass and total kinetic energy of all the particles about center of mass of the system. Now we will learn about linear momentum and its conservation. As we know, the time rate of change of the momentum of a particle is equal to the net force acting on the particle and it is in the direction of that force. Newton's second law, F equals to dP upon dt equals to d upon dt mv equals to ma. Now for a system of particles, the total linear momentum P is the vector sum of the individual particles linear momentum. Like this, P equals to P1 plus P2 dash 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 Pn if we are having n number of particles. Or we can write P equals to mvcm likh sakte hain ya vc. The linear momentum of a system of particles is equal to the product of the total mass. Here we can say product of the total mass of the system and the velocity of the center of mass. Now we can write dp upon dt equals to m dv upon dt equals to ma equals to dp upon net external force acting on the system. Conservation, if no external force acts on a closed isolated system of particles, the total linear momentum P of the system cannot change. Means if F equals to 0, then the net external force acting on the system is 0. If it is not isolated, each component of the linear momentum is conserved separately. If the corresponding component of the net external force is 0, This is for isolated and this is for closed. If the component of the net external force on a closed system is zero along an axis, component of linear momentum along that axis cannot change, means it will be constant. The momentum is constant if no external force acts on a closed particle system. Internal forces can change the linear momentum of portions of the system, but they cannot change the total linear momentum of the entire system. Thank you.